Remember, there are no rules in cooking. Taste this. So, big treat today. And we got a lot of good stuff going on here. So, thanks for tuning in to Taste This TV. Talking about truffles, which are my favorite. Now, there's a story about truffles. For people who don't know, some people might be thinking, is he talking about chocolate truffles? I'm definitely talking about mushroom truffles, a type of mushroom that's grown underground. And the smell alone is enough to drive me crazy. I love it. But now there's different kinds of truffles. Now there's sliced white truffles and sliced black truffles. Black are the least expensive. And then the white ones can go all the way up. The last price tag I heard was about $2,400 a pound. That's right. So it's a bit crazy in price. But I have hunted for truffles both in Italy and France. And it's funny because the first time I had hunted in Italy, in the Piedmont region of Italy, I was on this truffle fest. And I went with four other chefs and we flew down there. And, you know, we're walking with this guy who's loaded. I mean, they go packing. These things are like gold, right? So we walk with this guy. He's got the hat on, the pipe. It almost looks like, you know, you're going on a guided tour of like some costume type of festival. But it was the real deal. This is what they do every day. So we walk with this guide and, you know, everybody gets a cane because, you know, you're walking through the woods and stuff like that. They figure if you hit any snakes or whatever, you're welcome to be armed and bring a gun. I guess if you see a pheasant, you want to shoot out and cook too, which we, as chefs, we're ready to eat anything. So we're coming loaded. We're either catching bugs and eating them or animals, whatever. It's a fair game. But the main hunt is truffles. So we're walking through the forest. Everybody's got this stick. I suddenly felt like I was about 60 years older than what I am now. And we start walking, and the dogs that we had, I forgot the breed of dogs, but they definitely weren't your mixed breed from like a local shelter, come running over. And then they start like sniffing, and then they start to like vigorously dig into the dirt. And the owner goes, he starts yelling at the dog. The dog goes away. And I asked our guided tour guide, his assistant, you know, why he got so crazy with the dogs. And they said that, you know, it gets to a point where the dog actually starts to dig up the truffle, and he doesn't want the dog to actually pierce it, you know, but with his nails. So that's a little bit about that story. Now in France, they use pigs. The pigs sniff out the truffle. So I guess it's different wherever you go. Now I'm hearing that there's other countries that say they found the truffles and they're growing them there. I even heard the U.S. tried to grow the truffles as well. It's a prized item, and you'll find the most 3 or 4 star restaurants will have the actual sliced truffles. But the lower-class restaurants, and I mean that by no disrespect, but the price tag, which is a little lower, generally will just have the truffle oil, which is the fragrance of the truffle blended and infused in the oil, usually like a white truffle oil or something like that. But nevertheless, truffles, potatoes, and butter are some of my favorite to cook with, which is why I kind of love to cook items in the fall. I feel like this really goes well, although we're not in the fall when we're taping this now. A little secret. But anyway, I want to talk to you a little bit about what we're doing with this dish. It's one of my favorite dishes that I've ever done. And I had it in the restaurant for years. And it's called my black truffle wrapped salmon dish. So to get started, we got a lot of things going on here, you might see. I guess I can go over everything one by one. We got a piece of salmon, regular farm-raised salmon. I would have preferred to get a wild-caught salmon from Alaska. If you notice, the flesh is a little bit on the red tint when you deal with a wild-caught fish in Alaska as opposed to farm-raised. Farm-raised is a lot of stuff about farm-raised, you know, that I've read over the years. I haven't been to these farms, so I really can't back it up, but I was told that, you know, they'll feed them all different types of colorings to get the flesh to look like that. But anyway, if you were to go to Alaska and you got true salmon, or you know somebody that travels to Alaska and they ship you salmon to your door, you'll see that it's a reddish tint, and you can't get any better than the fish. It's just amazing. But this will work too, and this is fine. Now, I have some of my prized mushrooms here that we're going to talk a little bit about, chanterelles and shiitake caps. Both mushrooms are going to go perfect with this dish. What I'm going to do is do a little bit of a mushroom ratatouille. You could call it a mushroom duxelle, in which I infuse a lot of butter, a little bit of onions. We have cipollini onions here. And before we get started on that, on the actual salmon dish, we're going to go over to that hot pan there. We're going to take our knife. And what I'm going to do is just julienne some onions. And you don't have to chop them or dice them in any particular fashion. Just make sure that they're no thicker than that, because what's going to happen is we're going to saute them, and we want kind of get a little golden brown before we go to the next step. You don't need many either. So we're going to put the onions in. I always like to put the onions in first before the oil, because when I hear that, that tells me that when I put this oil in, it's going to go, you know, and I may even have to take it off the flame a little bit. But this is good. All right, so I like a lot of oil on this. And what we're going to do is raise this temperature up a little bit, put a little bit of salt and cracked black pepper right off the bat. That should do it. Okay, we don't want too much pepper because that'll just overpower the dish. We want just enough to enhance the flavor of the mushrooms. Now, you could grab some fresh shiitake mushrooms, your fresh chanterelles. These were actually dry, and I rehydrated them with some of my liquid. Now, the key in hydrating dried mushrooms is this, a little bit of white wine. I'm telling you, it goes a long way. A little bit of water, a lot of white wine, because you're going to get that flavor. It gives it a boost. See what I'm talking about? Some of these onions are now getting like nice and golden brown. Take your chanterelles, your shiitakes. I'm putting them all in there. The crew says they like mushrooms. I'll make extra. Now, I'm going to turn this back to the flame. I'm going to go into the refrigerator, get some more butter. Now, I have some regular butter, and I also have some really expensive truffle butter. I'm going to put them both in, but I'm going to put the truffle butter in at the very end, because I've found in my cooking that if you overcook something in the beginning, sometimes you can lose the truffle flavor. So we're just going to saute this like this. You see how this is coming together? We're going to lower the flame, because we want like a low stew on this. At the same time, I do want to come back here and tell you that I've been cooking some rice, and how I cook my rice is some people do 2-to-1. I do like 1-to-1 and add a little liquid at a time and bring it back to a low flame. You see how the grains on this rice, and it's hot. Right now I'm burning my hands, but I just wanted to show you that I don't get a sticky rice combination because I don't like my rice sticky. I do also wash it sometimes to get rid of all that starch. But back to the mushrooms. We're going to let that cook down. I'm going to add about 4 of butter. I'm going to put the butter aside. Okay, we're going to let our mushrooms cook down a bit. Now, before we get to our salmon, I just want to tell you what I've done to these potatoes. As you see, these potatoes have already kind of given off some of its color. It oxidized, and I take two back, and we're kind of back to the white surface. But what I did was I took this potato and sliced it very thin on the slicing machine. How thin, I couldn't tell you. I mean, it's just eye level. You can kind of see me right through the potato, so it's pretty thin. Next, what I want to do is take our fish, because this is whole part of the wrapping. They call it a brandade, if you wanted to get a fancy terminology here. So we got our salmon, and what we need to do is take the actual skin off. And that's pretty easy. I could show you a real basic technique. If this was a whole side of salmon in prior shows, you've probably seen that I start off a little bit, then I put a slit in here. And then I kind of roll it back, you know, because my finger could fit in this hole here. And then I start to gently pull back, see? See how it goes? Pull back, see? And see, look where my finger is. That's just an easy technique to try. And you know, a lot of people, it kills me too, because I mean, I go to some of these fish stores and I'm like, just because I don't want to deal with the mess, I'm like, can you take the skin off of me? Sometimes you get a guy that knows what he's doing. Sometimes you don't. I mean, you get a guy who's got like this much flesh. I'm like, man, I would have did it if I knew I was going to lose that much, you know? So, you know, you deal with that kind of stuff. So it's not hard to do it yourself, but you should know that, you know, there's different ways of doing it that could really help you. I'm just going to trim this a little bit. Now we're going to talk about this brandade technique. I'm not going to wash my hands yet. We put one potato down. Put another potato down here. Man, this is really the fragrance that's coming off of here, the aroma. Wow. Let me just give this a turn. Yeah, I mean, this is the way to do it, folks. This is the way to do it. It's real simple. I haven't really done anything out there that you can't follow. So we got potatoes. And see, I'm kind of overlapping it. And you want to try to go the length of the salmon. So in other words, if the salmon's going to be, all right, so I need about that much potato. This is really good because you can put anything underneath this potato that I'm going to show you. I'm obviously going to put these truffles in there. That's good. You know, let's do the sides too. This is an old favorite. I mean, many people that work with me in the restaurant industry are going to say, wow, yeah, I remember we used to have that. You do about 50 of these on a Saturday night. Now you have yourself a brand date. And you're going to take your salmon, and you're going to need to season it. A little salt. A little cracked black pepper. Now, some people might be saying, whoa, you should put some lemon on that. But I don't. I put orange on there. And I do that because lemons do not marry well with black truffles. Okay? So what I'm going to do is just put a generous amount of citrus on there because the citrus will help flavor the salmon. Okay? At the same time, what we want to do is take our black truffles and we want to put them right over the top of the fish. And this is where the patience comes in. So that's enough truffles. You don't want to overdo it. You got your truffles lined up over there. You say to yourself, are you good? I think we're good. The ends go first. They fold up. Now, it's like wrapping a present, like some kind of gift. You're going to take your knife, go right underneath it, and pull the first part over. Okay, now you're going to take this part and roll this over too. Now, you see how I just did that? Potatoes work really great because they're starchy. If you see like it's a little loose, just like a present where you put an extra little bit of tape, just pull it. Now you're good. Now what I'm going to do is sear this side down, seam side first. You take a little bit of oil. I like to use a nonstick pan, especially when you're messing around with this stuff. You know what I mean? Hey, let's turn this around. This is looking really nice. This is looking good. The rice is looking good. Let's get back to the fish. Okay, now, you have to be very careful. See, the fish is whole, it's wrapped up, go right down, seam side. And make sure, very gently, you move the fish. Because at this stage, if you can move it and it doesn't stick, it's never going to stick, you're in the clear. All you got to do is cook it, and you're going to have yourself a great meal. All right, what I'm going to do is take some of this stuff out of the way. I have a sanitary rag here. Little bleach solution. Wash my hands, wash the board, anything that I touch because we don't want any cross contamination. We're dealing with raw seafood. Now, what I will do at this point is salt the potato on the inner outside just a bit. Because I want to flavor that. Even though I've flavored the inside of the salmon, I now should season the potato. Now, very carefully, we're going to take a fish spatula. This is a fish spatula. It's a bit thin than a normal spatula. It's got a very kind of thin grooved front here that can slip right underneath the food. And what I'm going to do is just take a quick peek at that just to show you that that's not finished yet, but we're getting close. I'm going down. Now, salmon cooks relatively quick. It's an oil-based fish. It's filled with omega-3s. It's a very good healthy fish. It's flavorful fish to eat. While that's going, we're going to cook that nice and gently. Our mushrooms are cooking down nicely. We got our rice. So remember that rice I talked to you about that's not going to stick? This is it. And what we're going to do is we're going to take a little bit of truffle oil. Sorry, we're going to take a little truffle butter. And we're going to put that right in the hot rice. and keep it simple. Wow. And you do that right at the very end. So you can, wow. I mean, this is, grab a jar of this stuff. This is good. Now this sounds to me like it's almost ready. Sometimes you can hear this stuff when it's ready. We're gonna take it, flip it. Wow, that's what I'm talking about. Look at that. That's exactly what you want. You see the grooves on how that seared itself? It's like a present. Now the salmon itself, since it's in a pouch, it's almost like it's steaming. So we're about halfway cooked on this one. So, but do you see the black truffles on this? I love this dish. It takes a little while to do. It takes patience, but I'm telling you, you won't regret it. I also put a little olive oil in here. Excuse me. And a little bit of salt. I got my black truffled popcorn in here, too. I had some truffle oil. I popped it with some popcorn. That's my dessert. Wow. That's that aroma of truffles. You see what it does to the rice? It makes it nice and shiny. Now, this rice is cooked perfectly. You don't want to overturn it. So what you're going to do is have mashed potatoes because it'll start to break up. And we don't want that. Now our rice is finished. Maybe a little bit more salt without tasting it, if I had to guess. Okay. Now, let's start to clear this stuff up a little bit. At the very end of this mushroom dish that we got going on here, we're going to add some pinoli nuts, which would be a really good combination here. We're going to take a look at our other side of our salmon, which is perfect. And now we're going to leave our salmon on one side. We're going to cook the one side of the fish. We're going to flip it over, cook the other side, and they're ready to go. We're going to start the plate up. All right, so now we're just going to return this to the fire on very low. And you're really going to love this fish because it's got the starch in it that you don't need. It's sort of considered like a double starch, but I don't know. I just love rice with salmon, so I figured it would be a good idea. But let me wipe this down a little bit so we could focus on plating. What I want to do also, for a little color, for a little vegetable, and I do this at the very end, is just take some spinach and put it down like that. Now notice, this is fresh spinach. I want to talk to you a little bit about that because I don't open frozen spinach and throw it into my pot. I get fresh stuff, and notice I didn't like put a ton of oil in there or a ton of water, or I see sometimes people take spinach, they steam it first in a strainer and then they put it in hot oil. You don't even need to do that because look what happens. Eventually, all this wonderful fresh spinach is just going to wilt. And you don't need anything else but a little salt, which is exactly what I'm going to do now. Put a little salt. I'm just going to leave it kind of getting nice, doing its thing. Good. We'll turn this fish over. You see what I'm talking about? Take a look at that, folks. That's perfect. Simplicity at its finest. Our mushrooms, just about ready to go. Smells like the old days in the restaurant business. As you can see, the pinoli nuts are still holding its color. They're not turning brown. I sort of love this dish with the rice because what's going to happen is the oil and the butter from the actual mushrooms will get absorbed by the rice. So what I'm going to do is take a quenelle of rice. Put that neatly in the center. Next, we're going to take some of our mushrooms. The mushrooms are pretty serious. I mean, they got everything I'm looking for. And we're going to make sure you get those onions. You know, by now everything's mixed up, but I'm just saying. All right, we got our mushrooms. We're going to put that down there too. And if you feel like you love the taste of butter and the taste of truffles, you're going to put a little bit more on there. All right, now we're going to take our spinach. You see what I was talking about the spinach? Look, there's no liquid. You don't want like a sloppy mess, because what happens is when you do that kind of stuff with pre-poaching vegetables and then put, they leak out the water that you dredged them in, and it ruins your whole dish. It just kills your flavors. Look, Perfect. Put that right on top. Now, as you could probably guess, I'm putting my salmon right down here, like that. I mean, the only thing I left out is the singing. Should I spare everyone, or should I just start rolling with it? Okay. Hey, it took a while. This is the kind of effort that gets put into a really fine restaurant when doing high expensive items like truffle. If you wanted to take a little bit of sliced black truffles, put them on the top as a garnish. You could definitely do that. And if you haven't had enough with some of that flavor, just dig into this and you can put this around the plate. Just like that. Generally, we don't cut the fish. As you can see, it's a nice design. We don't want to cut it. But maybe I should cut it just to show you what it looks like inside, which would maybe help why I demonstrated the technique for it. So why don't we do that? Okay, we got ourselves a real sharp knife. We're just going to carefully cut the top. And what I'm really looking to show you is the layers of truffle, the doneness of the fish. As you can see, I'm just going to open this up. Camera guy can get in there. The fish is cooked perfectly, actually. Now you see the potato, and you see how it steams. I said once you kind of create that blanket, you get it. It almost steams and cooks your fish. And then you have these truffles that are right here that we put down, and really good. I mean, the flavor that's coming off of this, folks. I mean, listen, we're not talking about a mortgage payment here. The sliced black truffles aren't really that expensive. You can go grab a can at your local, probably specialty store. Make sure you grab the white truffle oil as well, because just because you have black truffles in a can, they're not going to smell like that truffle oil. So generally, you slice the truffles, you're going to put the truffle oil on them, and then you kind of come to that conclusion. Anyway, so I'm going to leave it like this. And then the rest is history. The rest is going to be me with a glass of wine and my popcorn afterwards. So again, the brandated salmon, which we had the potatoes, incredible truffles, spinach, rice, drizzled with the butter on top. You can't go wrong with that. And again, you could mix this around and put any kind of mushroom that you wanted. I only wanted to put these two because they're really earthy mushrooms, and they create the flavor of the truffles as well. Well, that's going to about do it for this episode of Truffles. Thank you for watching this fun-filled episode of Taste This TV. I'm your host, Chef Joe Simonero. Remember, there are no rules in cooking. Taste this.